New this morning, a Sacramento high school expecting a special visitor today. KCRA3's Leticia Ordaz joins us live from Hiram Johnson. Without Dr. Oz, we'll take part in a healthy breakfast challenge. Leticia.
Well, good morning. In just about 1 hour, Dr. Oz will arrive, and students here are so excited here. This is a part of an English class that wrote Dr. Oz, asking him to visit, and of course, Dr. Oz agreed, and they are going to be taking part in a food challenge. We're talking about four different teams, and Dr. Oz is going to be judging their healthy breakfast, and I'm here now with one of the coordinators of the program, and tell me a little bit more about how excited you guys are about the visit.
We are super excited about the visit because the students wrote letters from the heart that actually expressed the fact that they were learning something healthy in the classroom, and they wanted the source and the founder of the program to actually come here and really see what is happening at the school.
Okay, let's talk to the students. Ryan, tell me a little bit more about how you feel about Dr. Oz coming to town today.
I'm really excited. I'm glad to see that he's here, and I would like to show him that we students can make healthy food and teach others how to make healthy breakfast, so we're not eating junk like Fruit Loops or any of that stuff, like sugary cereal.
What food are you planning to prepare for him today?
We're making yogurt parfaits, which is a very healthy supplement for any over sugar cereal. You know, so we have fresh fruit, granola, strawberries, yogurt. It's very healthy and it's all low fat, so, and it's very filling.
And have you changed the way you live after listening to Dr. Oz and his message about obesity?
A lot. I've started eating a lot more fresh fruit, vegetables, and I help my parents make healthy food at home. So we're eating a lot less fried food and a lot more healthy food.
Oh, sounds great. Okay. And Sarah, just quickly, how do you feel about Dr. Oz coming to your school today, and what do you think it will mean for students?
It feels really good to know that we actually brought him here. We spent so much time preparing for him to come. And the letters, we really wrote really good letters to him, and it's good that he actually read them.
All right. What's the one message that you said in the letter that you think got him to come here?
That he's changing things here for
changing
us.
Lives for students and fighting obesity. Reporting live here at Hiram Johnson High School, Leticia Ordaz, KCRA 3 Reports.
All right. Thank you, Leticia.